What is good, friends? We are back with more OUPL content. Finals, OUPL finals, Roses versus Black Oblivion, and the team from the Kevai, the anti team, Kevai Kratos Manas, they are up 3-1. And I think Black Oblivion is on Maddie's team. I'll just check real quick. He brought a really wild Sun team. Yeah, anti's team is up 3-1. So if Roses wins this and Ricardo wins was top tier later on, they will win OUPL, because then it's gonna be 5-1. That the series is already decided. Yeah, he leads up with a Torkoal, goes for a Lava Plume on a Greninja, doesn't get a burn. I don't know why he stayed in with a Torkoal. So he brings Sun, which probably is that why. It could also be Zardex to try and catch the opponent off guard. But yeah, Pearl. I was mixing up Pearl with Roses. Roses does miss a Will-O-Wisp there, which sucks. There was a defensive Lanners, I would assume. It's Solar Power Zard. What? Is it even Mega then? Is it Mega Venusaur and regular Zard? That would be fire. You never know. It could also be Mega Zem. You never know. That's another option. But I was thinking that it's like Sash Zem at first. But that's the thing, it has Solar Power, so it really makes me think that he's not Mega. That is, if this has a HP Ice, the Zayat would get blown away. Everything else gets kind of cooked by Fire Blast. Pretty sure that's Scarf Latios and Rose's team. Oh my lord, did you see that damage? Is that Specs or something? Yeah, he's Scarf Latios and he does trick, and the Midjourney gets the Assault Vest trick away. So I can see the Flash Cannon slash Volt Switch coming out here. If you don't wanna, if Rose doesn't wanna risk the Zygarde, Tangros is an option, but he just stays in with a Latios. So maybe he just predicted the Volt Switch, because Latios can eat that up. And it was, like, it makes sense that he would go for Volt Switch there, but going to Zygarde would have put in a lot of work too for Roses. So yeah, I like Azamat Speedsters for sure after I tricked the Scarf away. The Avimon is either going to be the Tang or the Midjourney, but I'm thinking that the Midjourney might be Z-move. So I'm thinking it's AV-Tang at the moment. So this Mew, the way he brings this Mew in makes me think it's a bit more Spidef. HP Fire and the Sun does a lot, but it doesn't do enough. So Mew's just gonna go for Roost slash Soft Bolt. Same thing. Oh, he didn't. Did he predict him to have Taunt on his Zam? If he didn't have predict him to have Taunt, that was a cool play. He's probably just gonna knock off here. Get rid of the damn Heat Rock. I said damn Brock at first because I see rain everywhere on the ladder. Why am I lagging? So yeah, I assume the Torkoal is gonna get up the rocks or Lava Plume. The Landers could also have Star Rocks. So maybe just, yeah, he just goes for Lava Plume, kills the Latios. And Zygarde can come in here. Oh, Greninja, okay. But didn't he switch out the Greninja earlier? On this Torkoal, which was weird. Maybe, oh, he probably predicted the Midjourney to come out earlier. This is why he switched out. He gets a crit there, which is, it specs Ash Gwen. That might have mattered. I will calc real quick. Greninja, are you Ash or is this a Torkoal? I don't know his Torkoal spread. If he's Spidef, that probably mattered. Let's give him max HP. I'll pump this. Oh my lord, 200%, but the Sun is not. There's 117 if he doesn't have any Spidef. If he's just max HP. Yeah, the HP Fire is an option here, breaking the Midjourney. Giga Drain is also. Giga Drain is pretty much a fine play. I think that Roses might sack the Mew here. Just going hard Midjourney on a potential HP Fire would not be the play. If you predict HP Fire, you can go Zygarde. The Venusaur can also go for Growth and just do even more damage. He said, of course, so maybe the crit mattered. Like if you give the Torkoal max bedev, like without his bedev nature, then Pump's level is done 87 to 103. Oh, he wasn't in his Ash form. I calced Ash Greninja, that was my fault. I mean, he got his Ash form activated, but he wasn't in his Ash form yet, so... let's say it's just a regular Greninja, we give him a choice bags as the Mew came out on the... on the Venusaur and gets picked up by HP Fiber's Giga Drain. And we see it's a Life Orb Venusaur. So I assume we're gonna see the Zygarde slash Magearna here. The Sun is still up for 3 turns. But yeah, regular Greninja with a choice specs, Hydro Pump. Twist with Death Talk in the Sun would have done 65%, and if it's just max HP, 65 to 77. If it's max HP, it would have been a roll, so yeah. If the Torkoal just has a little bit of Spadef, the crit matter probably, yeah. Damn, this team is kind of putting in the work, though. The BBC Kings always bring fire teams. Medi brought it with those cream teams. I don't know if Medi built this one, but... most of the time... he builds those, or at least he gives his ideas. Not sure if he builds every single one himself. Yeah, the Zygarde is gonna click Thousand Arrows or Outrage. I think Thousand Arrows is more likely. As it's a defensive Landorus and eats it up completely. Yeah, this would have been burned, but the crit also potentially mattered, so that's kinda, we're kinda even on Hex at the moment. So we're gonna see U-turn from the Landorus here. Just to keep our momentum. Cause if the Tangros comes out here and he goes for U-turn, Zadwai gets a Zad gets the fire of a fire blast. I said Zadwai because of the Sun, but yeah, it's actually Mega Zam. Damn, didn't I like at first I thought it was Mega Zard and it was like it could be Mega Venusaur, but I didn't think I realized that it could be Mega Zam too. It's a cool play there, taking advantage of the Sun being up, going for HP Fire on the Magearna. He didn't want to risk the Zard on a potential Rock Slide or potential knockoff. But you know the Zard is in, it's just gonna click Fire Blast here. Zygarde can come in on this, but I don't think it's worth it to click HP Ice if he has it. Like, I think he's just gonna click Fire Blast, he doesn't lose too much as long as he hits, he gets good damage off. And Landorus can still check the Zygarde. It can come in one more time on the Zygarde. He goes for Specs, as Legend does a lot. He's timid, he outspeeds the Zygarde, but Zygarde tend to run Adamant anyway, so the Zard should be faster. So this regular Zard putting in the work, my lord. I did not expect this. I could see the Magearna coming out here. He's probably gonna go Magearna because he's locked into Air Slash. And I can see Black Oblivion doubling into the Landorus. I would say you could see him doubling the Torkoal if Torkoal was still alive, but Torkoal is dead, so there's dead. Like, I usually, we have this one guy on our chat and he always jokes about Charizard putting in work. And he's like 13 years old or something and like, and really, like, I kind of laugh about, like, I don't want to say he's bad or anything, but like, I didn't never think that Zard would put in such work in a game like this, in a tour game. There was Shifugi Magearna and maybe he doesn't have Ice Beam or Floorcan. Maybe he only had Flash Cannon, T-Bolt and something else. Otherwise he should have been able to pick off the Landorus there. Black Oblivion gets in the Magearna on the knockoff, which is a cool play. Cause now he's able to switch up moves, even though switching up moves doesn't really matter. It's pretty low anyway, and most of the time he's just going to be clicking Volt Switch, which is Magearna. And I mean, he can click Floorcan here, predicting Tangles to stay in, but he didn't do that. So the Zard just gets picked off, and we confirm that it's Choice Spec Zard, because it gets knocked off. Yeah, I think I would have Floorcan there if he has it. That was a bit odd. I guess he predicted the Magearna to come out, and the Tangrowth would have gotten regenerated, so the play makes sense somewhat. Like, I can understand the play. Like, I believe he's still in a good position. I assume he might just go for HP Fire here. And yeah, Magearna is a bit annoying for Black Oblivion, but other than that, it's looking pretty good. And oh, Greninja is also a threat, kind of, but Alakazam keeps it in check. If it doesn't have Dazzling Gleam, it relies on Focus Blast, though, to kill the Greninja, which is going to be a bit annoying. Because we all know how Focus Blast goes, that move likes to miss a bit more often than you would like it to miss. Oh, I just want to see if Padlop won his ladder game. Padlop lost, okay. He was laddering on the second ult. He's on 700 there, okay. Yeah, I assume we're gonna see HP Fire come out here, because the... I mean, Magearna is not a Salt Vest, but it can still come in Sludge Bomb, so there's always that. And if Tangrowth gets regenerated, I can still take a hit from Mega Alakazam, probably. I can also take a hit from Landorus. But Venusaur, like, Landorus can always U-turn out on Tangrowth anyway and bring in the Venusaur. But it's the life of Venusaur, it's not weak, like, you don't make jokes about this mod. You suspect Zard was strong, life of Venusaur strong too. Like, these starters getting some love, you're putting in the young world. Both timers are ticking down. I mean, I can completely understand it. I also, like, I wouldn't know immediately what I would do here if I was Roses. Like, it's tough. But yeah, as I expected, HP Fire comes out. Like, he could have gone Greninja there, but that was super risky. So he's gonna go for Shift Gear, because I think he has to go for a game with his Magearna. Looks like his win con. Other than that, dodging a Focus Blast with Greninja might also be a win con. But the thing is, I think he might have to... Magearna probably lives to Dark Pulse. The Salt Vest got knockoff, but still probably max HP Magearna, right? Like, it's a max HP Magearna, not probably. Because the Salt Vest, they all run max HP, right? So, Hydro Pump. If he locks the Greninja into Hydro Pump to kill the Magearna, then Venusaur gets a kill. And if he locks into Dark Pulse, then Magearna is a problem. So, Roses has to play Greninja well, but it's gonna be tough. Because he only has, like, one sack. If he can't win with this Magearna. So, like, I don't see him winning with Greninja, is what I'm trying to say, because he only has one sack in Magearna. And I feel like going for a game with Magearna is the way to go. So he's gonna Shift Gear here, I assume. But if he doesn't have a move to kill the Landorus, I don't see how he's winning. Maybe he has Floorkin. I didn't want to risk the Floorkin earlier, not sure. Last week's game was hilarious, by the way, between Roses and I forgot his opponent. It was like Z Happy Hour Jirachi, and Roses got some hacks. And it was like, the threat after the game was like a GG Easy or something like that. It was kind of funny to me. It's Earthquake, Venusaur for Heatran, and that's a cool tech. Shifty comes out, and if it doesn't have Ice Beam, I don't think Flash can kill it. Oh, Z-move might kill. Pretty sure this is Z-move. Because it was Scarf, this is Specs, this is Lefty's AV, and this is Bandit. There's pretty much this team is kind of standard, especially compared to this team. This team is some fire. You may see like three standard mons on here. Even then, Mega Alakazam is not that common, but it's pretty cool because you can trade a lot of good abilities. And people also do not expect Mega Zam when you see Zard and Venusaur. I don't think they would expect it when they see it first. If he has Ice Beam, this game should be over. But he does have Ice Beam. So did he predict this to be Yachi Landorus? Because early he didn't go for it, if he knew. So now you can just click it again and get the Soul Heart boost. And I think Flash Can might kill this. Oh, Z-move. Yeah, Z-move should kill this. Like, I assume this will be Bolt Beam Magearna with Focus Blast. If it's not Focus Blast, I assume it's Flash Cannon or Flare Cannon. Yeah, but the Z-move should definitely be able to kill Alakazam. He's at a Gigavolt Havoc or a Corkscrew Crash? What's the other thing called? Twinkle Tackle? Yeah, I don't think he's Twinkle Tackle. Oh, All Out Pummeling. All Out Pummeling might not kill because Z-Focus Blast. So if he only has Ice Beam, T-Bolt, regular moves, and Z-Focus Blast, I don't think he can kill the Zam. So yeah, he doesn't have Gigavolt Havoc or anything like that. And he has to go for Water Shuriken here to kill this, because Alakazam outspeeds Greninja. And then Venusaur just wins. Black Oblivion takes the win for Matibotic's team. That's Rayscarvid. Rayscarvid, what was that shitty Magearna who stabs? Dazzling Gleam, so he doesn't have to rely on Focus Blast. Yeah, he didn't go for Water Shuriken because that cannot kill a Venusaur. So he had to rely on a Focus Blast dodge there if it was Focus Blast, but it was just Dazzling Gleam. And he made the score, he made it 2-3 now, Black Oblivion with picking up the win for his team. So the games left are, the score is 2-3 now. Gypsy vs TDK, hope this is gonna happen. T vs Tony and Top Devourers Ricardo. I know that Top Devourers Ricardo should happen in like 50 minutes, so I'm pretty hyped for that. I will up, why can I not talk? I will be uploading most of these games, one day after they happen, or 2 days. I recorded the Astro series today, and I'll also be recording Astros tomorrow, so don't really know in which order I will upload this. I will upload one or two OUPL games Monday, before Smoktos probably. I'm not 100% sure, but thank you guys for watching. Stay tuned for more content, and Dark Witch signing out. Peace.